Welcome to the Team Engagement Podcast, where leaders of teams share their insights. Brought to you by Blue Sky Business Consulting, we discuss five questions in about 15 minutes.
And hello again. We're glad that you could join us here on the Team Engagement Podcast. We're excited to have you join us every week. And this week, I'm excited to introduce Eric Dahl. He is the founder and CEO of Davis Dahl Marketing right here in Salt Lake in Utah. So we are very excited to have you here, Eric. Thanks so much for taking time to join us. What would you like the audience to know about Davis Dahl?
Well, first of all, Sean, thanks for having me on the podcast. I've been looking forward to this. So Davis Dahl is a digital marketing agency. My partner, Gardner Davis, and I, we have a long track record in marketing. But, you know, our special sauce is spending a little bit more time trying to understand each one of our clients so that when we craft messaging, campaigns, whatever the case is, that it's done thoughtfully and impactfully. So we're bombarded by thousands of messages every day, but we all crave the memorable ones. So we're always trying to create memorable messages that will resonate and not get lost in the white noise that already exists.
Oh, I like that. Yeah, that's a tough, now that the world has gone more global and everybody can be on the internet more or less, it's more and more important to really distinguish yourself and be memorable, as you said. So I like that. All right, well, let's go ahead and get started with our questions then. Now, Eric, as you guys have been building your business, is there a challenge that you've overcome that you're especially proud of?
So I think that, you know, there is no golden destination per se. I think that it's ongoing. And but along the way, I think being true to our own talents and capabilities, not trying to be everything to everyone or not trying to be like another agency in this case, but being true to our talents while providing the most value to them, those clients, is mission critical. And so, you know, if we are ongoing able to do these things, then I think that we're going to be successful. And that's where I'm proud of the work that we do when we are working to that end.
I love that. That's great. All right. Well, question number two, how can a leader of a company or leaders of a company kind of create an environment of creativity and being able to innovate a little bit? But what are some of your ideas on that?
Yeah, and this is a great question because I feel like I can go back and throughout my life and learning from some of the leaders that I've been surrounded by. And I feel like the leaders that have made the most impact for me personally have been the ones that have encouraged me and sought to understand my unique capabilities and to build momentum on those rather than trying to, you know, force a square peg into a round hole type of a clay. And so if, you know, if there's encouragement, if there's autonomy to build things in the way that you're proud of, I feel like that's where the greatest success opportunities lie. And for people to feel the most value and to, you know, feel good about themselves and to contribute at a very high level.
That's great. Thank you. Question number three, how can leaders of an organization, a team, company, whatever, how can they help their team members learn to trust each other?
Yeah. And I think that, you know, a couple of sayings come to mind. The first one is that trust is earned. And, you know, there's another saying by Woody Allen, who's a filmmaker, who says that 80% of success is just showing up. But within that statement, I think, you know, there's the key to it, which is, if you're consistent, if you're showing up and contributing to where, whether it's your boss, whether it's your coworker, if they know that you're going to be there and they can count on you to come in and to do the work that is, you know, laid out before us as a team, then that's where that trust can be earned. That's where, you know, we believe in each other and know that we're going to get things done because we've been through battles before and we've come out on top. And so, you know, there's always ups and downs. There's always things that we're battling through, but at the core, if we know that we can rely on each other, I think that is so, so important.
Great comments. I really liked what you talked about. I know you were quoting Woody Allen, but 80% is just showing up. It kind of begs the question, what does it really mean to show up? And you elaborated a little bit about, you know, coming and doing the work that's before us and those kinds of things. But it really does, from a leader's perspective, it really does. You got to kind of pause a little bit and say, okay, team members or employees, I like to call them team members rather than employees, but what does it mean to show up? What is it, you know, not just here you are, because especially in this world where we're all remote and whatnot, you don't always know if they're physically at their station, so to speak.
Sure. Yeah.
But it's a great question about what does it mean to show up?
Yeah. And I think that, you know, the short answer, at least in my book, is because you're right. People can show up and they can be on cruise control and just not a lot of help. But if they show up and have a can-do mentality where they're willing to roll the sleeves up, and if, you know, they can go in 100 different direction based off of what the need is, but if they have a can-do mentality, that's where, you know, things are going to get done. And going back to the question, trust is earned quickly.
Yes. Oh, I like that. Very good. All right. Question number, I see what we have to number four here. Okay. So, now, Eric, as I'm sure this has never happened to you, but sometimes people experience a certain measure of setbacks or even failure, as they define it. But is there a failure that maybe was a failure at the time, but you've since been able to turn it into a win?
Yeah. And I think all of us have gone through, you know, ups and downs and wins and failures. I think that the easiest thing that comes to my mind is looking at my career. The first half of my career, I was in real estate investment, and, you know, it was a great time. We were very successful. And I thought that, you know, as a 25-year-old kid, I had the tiger by the tail and everything was wonderful until something called the recession hit. And that really kind of changed everything for me overnight, it felt like, and forced me to reevaluate in an industry that was no longer producing paychecks for me. And so I had to figure out where I was going to go. And, you know, understanding my background, my father was in advertising for years. I felt like I had some good creative chops. And so this reinvention process began where I took a job as a vice president of marketing in a business in an industry that I had no business of having that job, but went in and reinvented myself as a marketer, and along the way figured out this is where I should have been all along. And so you just keep going. You know, there's times in your life where good people with good hearts will say it'll get better. And sometimes there's a lot of, you want to believe those people, but things can get very dire and it may not resonate, but they're right. Things always get better as long as you keep on marching. And so that's one that, you know, deep wounds that with scars that may not ever fully heal in my life, but turning a disappointment, a failure into an ongoing success in the transition from one industry into another.
I really like that. I especially like that phrase, march forward. Just keep marching. Just go, go, go. Stick with it, and it will get better, because that's how we get better, is to just keep going. So I love that comment. All right, our last question. Tell us a little bit about your first job.
Yes. So my first job was with a company called Ward's Discount Carpets, which is a group here in Salt Lake City. They lived in my neighborhood, and I helped move carpets in a carpet store and cleaned up behind the scenes. And I learned something very quick right out of the gates, which was carpet is heavy and carpet can break your back because it's so heavy. But, you know, you learn to adapt, and a lot of learning experiences, a lot of good things came out of that first gig with Ward's Discount Carpets. And so, I'm grateful for my short time there, but, that was my first job.
Oh, I love it. I think you're the first carpet man, I'll call you to be on the show here, but, yeah, I've lifted a little bit of carpet in my time, but nothing like that. So I'm sure it's a lot heavier than we sometimes give it credit for. So, all right, Eric. Well, thank you again for taking time to be on the podcast today. How can people find you?
Yeah, they can find me at our website, which is davisdahl.com, or reach out and connect with me on LinkedIn. Would love to connect with you there as well.
Great. Well, thanks again, everyone. We appreciate everyone joining us every week. And we look forward to being with you again next week. Thanks so much. Have a great day.
This is Sean Richards with the Team Engagement Podcast, where leaders of teams share their insights. For more ideas, go to teamengagementpodcast.com. We also invite you to follow or subscribe to our podcast wherever you may be listening or watching. Is your business thriving? Go to tbs-score.com to find out. Thanks for joining us today. Have a great day.